Hey everyone, and welcome to the channel. Today, we'll dive into Power BI, and create a visually appealing dashboard, tracking projects' progress using an S-curve. An S-curve represents the cumulative work accomplished over time. It's a valuable tool in project management, offering insights into progress, potential delays, and resource allocation. Here is the data set for our project management dashboard. The data contains end-of-month dates, month count, total budget, budgeted cost, actual cost, and their cumulative figures. There are three projects currently in progress, or recently completed. We will evaluate these projects, using the S-curve in our Power BI dashboard. To load the data from Excel file, click on the Excel workbook button. Locate and select the file you want to load, and press Open. In the Navigator window, select the table you want to load, and press the Load button. Depending on the volume of data, it may take some time to load the data. Wait for the loading process to complete. Once the table is loaded, it will be available in the Data pane, along with its fields, which can be used in visualizations. To start with your dashboard, insert a text box, and place it at the top of the dashboard. Then, enter an appropriate title for your dashboard, and select appropriate font size. Place it appropriately at the top of the screen, and turn on visual borders as well. After creating a title, go to the Visuals pane, and insert a button slicer, to your dashboard. Place the slicer at the top left corner. Add the project number field, from progress table, to the button slicer. Go to the slicer layout settings, and change it to a single column layout. Turn on visual borders, and set the corners as well. Go to the slicer settings, and turn on the force selection option. We do not want to display the information of all projects together, which will only mess up the S-curve. Insert a card visual, and place it next to the button slicer. Using the Add Data button, add the budgeted field to the card slicer. Go to the Size and Style area, and turn on the visual borders. Also set the rounded corners to 5px. Make a copy of the card visual, and place it next to the existing one. Using the Build a Visual button, replace the budgeted field with the actual field. Next, we need a combo chart, which we can create using the line and column chart. Add the month field to the x-axis of the line and column chart. Add the budgeted field to the column y-axis of the line and column chart. And finally, add the cumulative budgeted field to the line y-axis of the visual. Now, we need to convert this line and column chart into a combo chart. To do that, we need to find the secondary y-axis settings and turn on the secondary y-axis. Here it is. Go to the values toggle button and simply turn it on. Then, go ahead and turn on the visual borders as well, setting the rounded corners to 5px. And you have just created the S-curve, which you can tell from its S-like shape. Create a copy of the combo chart, and place it next to the existing one. Replace the budgeted field with the actual field. Replace the budgeted total field with the actual total field. In the following example, the actual progress could not follow the planned project timeline, and it fell back a little in the beginning, which was covered in the final stages of the project, causing the sigma shape of the S-curve to change. This can be further analyzed by comparing the actual and planned progress in a single chart. Create a copy of the line and column chart, and place it at the bottom right corner. Replace the actual field with the budgeted total field. We want to compare both cumulative fields. It is better to change it into a line chart. Now, you can observe that the actual line has been below the budgeted line during the entire project timeline. However, at the end both lines managed to meet, as actual progress caught up to the planned progress. For our final visual, copy a card visual and place it at the top right corner. Change it to a gauge visual. We need the actual field in the value area and the budgeted field in the maximum area. This will display the progress of the project, which in this case is 100%, as the project has completed in February. Our dashboard is now complete. We can use the button filter to select a project and track its progress using the S-curve and the gauge visual. Thanks for watching. We hope you liked our tutorial. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the bell icon for more insightful tutorials and updates.